Everybody speak English, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. The youngest one can understand English. Right? I will talk only to you now. Okay, so I'm an ad guy, I'm an advertising creative director, and I do that for like 10, 15 years, but I also do a lot of other things, as you just heard. But I always come back to advertising because I think advertising has a lot of power and a lot of significance. Power that kind of moves us forward and power that kind of creates popular culture, and it also helps us living in the city. Now, you probably think that advertising is not very significant, especially if you want to watch your favorite soap opera on Yoku, and you have to wait for those bloody 15-second ads to disappear, sometimes even 13 or 45 seconds, and I also really hate them. I hate advertising like that. And that's not what I want to talk to you about today. I want to talk to you about advertising that creates experiences and a new kind of form of advertising that thrives off collaboration and technology. And there's a lot of stuff going on, and it's about now not creating communication that interrupts people's life, but communication that is useful and that is entertaining and that people actually seek out and want to experience. So I will show you a project that I worked on later, but before we do that, which way is it? Can you click for me? Thank you. Just a quick lesson on what is advertising. It's actually very simple. It always starts with a strategy, and the strategy is you need to understand a lot. You learn a lot in advertising about consumers, about brands, about the environment, about competition, about the product. And all of this knowledge gets filtered down in a message. That's the message we want to communicate. Once we have the message, it goes over to click, to creativity. And then we can think about how we're going to communicate that message. And that has always been the case, strategy and creativity. But over the last 5 to 10 years, something new came into the picture. Thank you. Technology. And technology changes everything, not only changes our life. You know, everybody has an iPad, a mobile phone. We spend endless amounts of time on Weibo and on Yoku. But it also changes the way we think about people. Now we have to understand how people act with digital devices, how people consume content. And we also have to create new kind of creative work that uses that technology to create a better experience. So we work with a lot of different kinds of people, from architects to technologists, to create those kind of experiences. And I personally believe that this intersection of technology and creativity in the advertising world, connected to brands, has a very strong impact on all of our popular culture, because there's a lot of magic happening between technology and creativity. Oops, back one. Okay. So, very interesting. That's brand new, 2011. If you look at 2006 television advertising spend, this is from America, but it doesn't really matter, was 41% of all money was spent on thinking. It's the wrong clicker. Okay. 41% of all money was spent on television, only 23% on digital communication. And now, in 2011, look at that, it's 38% is spent on digital. So digital and technology really changes our lifestyle completely, and less we watch television. I personally probably consume 70% per day in digital media and only 20 or 30% in traditional media. So that has a very strong impact on how we do things. And this one is really amazing. Just last month, for the first time ever, the sales of smartphones, iPhones and Samsung Galaxy, actually outpaced the sale of PCs and notebooks. If you think about that, for the first time in history, we have much more computing power in our pockets than we actually have on our desktop. So that has a really big impact, and if you see that, how this grows, the smartphones and the other one is tablets, it really will change a lot about the way we interact with ourselves and with brands over the future. So I want to show you what kind of impact that has on the work I do, and this is a project that we tried to move into this new kind of area of creativity and technology. It was a campaign, an advertising campaign done for a car. It's a city car. It's called the Scirocco, and it's a very sporty kind of, sexy kind of dynamic car that attracts a certain kind of urban lifestyle people. And we found that this car only comes out at night. Funnily enough, you never see this car by daytime because the people who drive it, they're like clubbing and eating and cinemas that all come out at night. So we had this positioning of the car comes out at night, bring on the night. And then we thought, what are we going to do? A print ad, maybe the print ad could sound something like some people have all their fun after dark. We could even go further, have something about vampires that come out at night. But it's all a bit boring, and we thought, how can we create something, an experience that, people want to be involved in, that people seek out, and people don't really want to read ads the same way you don't want to see the ad in front of your Yoku TV show. So we had this idea of creating a story. It's a story that plays out in a graphic novel. A graphic novel is something everybody really likes to read. And we said, people don't like print ads. Maybe start with a story on a print ad, but we continue the story on a mobile phone. They can also continue the story on your desktop PC. So we set out to create a story, an interactive story that plays out across different channels. And we used a technology called HTML5 to make it a seamless experience between all kind of devices. Now this creation process of a story, this is really where there's a lot of fun. Here's a mock-up of the booklet. It's also been a booklet, a printed comic book booklet. It plays in the dark city. We then went on to find some kind of style reference, found images from Steve Missel, a very famous photographer. And then we thought about how about we mix photography with illustration. We thought about the kind of style we want to communicate and what kind of impact and drama we want to have the characters to wear. And then we thought we have to create an authentic kind of story. We don't want to create an ad, we want to create something of authenticity. And we went out and collaborated with a writer. And this writer up here is called Andy Diggle. And we found him, he's a very famous Marvel comic and DC comic writer. This is something of real substance, and he agreed. He said, yeah, I would love to write a story that has that car in it. And how about you also work with my illustrator, Chock? And illustrator Chock is a very famous illustrator who do a lot of great Batman images, etc. We said, that's great, cool. Let's all collaborate together. Let's bring illustration, photography, technology, and storytelling together and create this the story. And then Andy said, okay, I have a story for you. It's called The Kingdom of Night. It plays in a city, but it also plays an ancient magic kingdom. And it's a full story with a hero, which by coincidence is a teacher, a beautiful girl, an evil prince of night, his father, and a nightmare, which is a horse. So a very kind of intriguing, interesting story. Then Chuck drew out the frames of the story. There's 45 frames to the story. And you see here the hero being a DJ, you see the Prince of Night, you see the ancient kingdom, and of course the car is the real hero, so we have a lot of cars in here, and even more cars, and there's also the evil father. So this is how the storyboard looked like. We had to then shoot all of that, 45 panels, and went into a studio, and there's another German photographer, I'm not sure if you know, but car photographers are 99% German, because they're very diligent and very detail-oriented, care about quality, so they are all car photographers. And the fashion photographer is much more sexy, he's an Italian guy. So he's really good at working with the models, and he was a very fun character. He then came up with his own ad. He said, want the girl, buy the car. That was his contribution to it. And we worked really hard. We found a guy from the architecture faculty in Kafa to design the costume for the Prince of Night or for the King of Night. And he was very tired, we made him work overnight. Poor student. Then the photographer and the illustrator started to drink beer in the car, took out the window for that. Even the cat started to drink Genshin beer. And then we started to photograph all of that, and there was the King of Night then that turned into something like this, and it really turned out into some kind of amazing visual experience for us. This is Yo-Yo, the second hero in the story, the magic kind of girl, so this looked all very fantastic. We were very excited about it, and then we got Chok and my friend Fang to sit down for 2 weeks and put this all together. So it's a lot of laborious process to do that. And I just want to quickly share with you this story and see what you think of it. It's called Kingdom of Night. And it's done by Andy Diggle and Chuck. The problem in advertising is you never get to put your name onto it. It's always other people who take all the credit for it. So Ouyang is a DJ. He arrives at the club late at night with his girlfriend Yoyo, and she says, "Oh, we're way too early. Let's go for another drive." And she says, "Oh no, let's not go for another drive. I think we love your car more than you love me." And he says, "Oh no, I definitely love you more than the car." And they go inside the club, and he starts bidding the DJ, and his friend walks over and says, "Have you seen that Yoyo is talking to some stranger at the bar?" And he says, "Oh no, what is that?" And he walks over and she says, "It's not what you think it is." He says, "Well, I think it's what I think it is." And he takes her away, and then the guy at the bar turns into the immortal Prince of Night, an ancient warrior of magic and fear, and he challenges Ouyang for a race, and the winner would get Yoyo for eternity, forever. So it's a very, very big challenge. And then Ouyang takes it on, and they go outside the club, and the Prince of Night claps his hands, and a magic horse comes out of a magic circle of magic. And he gets on the horse, off he goes. Ouyang, Yoyo jump into the car, and off they go as well. And then they go through a high-speed chase through the city and through probably Shanghai. And then the prince says, "Oh my god, those cars get faster and faster. What am I going to do? I'm going to cut those light poles off." And then on your mobile phone, you can actually steer around those light poles. But that doesn't help. The car still catches up, and he jumps through a magic circle of light. And Ouyang says, "Oh, it's a magic circle of light. Let's go in there as well." And off they go, and they end up in the Kingdom of Night. He says, "Oh my god, what is this? Even my GPS doesn't work in the Kingdom of Night." And then the bridge erupts, and the King of Night comes and says, "What are you doing in my kingdom?" And the car magically disappears because of all its power. And he says, "Your fears will amplify, and those two drift apart." And Ouyang says, "No, I'm going to be stronger than you." And they hold each other, come back together. The king says, "Oh no," the car reassembles, is magically supercharged, shoots through the King of Night, explodes into a thousand pieces, and the car goes back through the circle of light, lands in the streets of Shanghai on Yananlu, goes through Yananlu, arrives at the club, comes to a halt, and who won? Of course, Ouyang. And turns out that Yoyo was also a magic kind of princess of night, and now they're together forever, and they drive off to Beijing. And this story you got in print ads and in magazines, but it's always the teaser you became, and then you had to use your mobile phone to get to the whole story. And this is really what people really appreciated, and people appreciated that it was a full entertaining story. There was a lot of people, and I think I have those numbers here, it's like 3 million people who actually read this story on their mobile phone. They probably sat in subways and ran through it. On Weibo, it was like 2 million forwards of this story, and also people afterwards thought that the brand, because we gave such a good experience, was 20% more favorable. They liked the brand 20% more. So this is really how new kind of campaigns and new kind of advertising and creativity works in communication. You have an idea, and then it goes through so many different kind of new channels that together create this experience. There was an app, there was a website, there was a Weibo, there was a game, etc. And it takes a lot of people to work together on this. So those kind of experiences are all done in collaboration. So this is really what I want to communicate to you. It's all about moving things forward into popular culture, to push the boundaries, to connect technology with creativity. No matter what it is it advertising, is it architecture? And then you create experiences that people really like and seek out to. Thank you very much.